it is any scientist's ultimate aim to win the Nobel Prize. Since
it's a kind of dream or something way off. Many excellent scientists can do wonderful things, but there are very few Nobel Prizes. You have to, a lot is required. And one thing that is required is luck. The most important lucky thing you need is to be born at the right time. So, there's a saying that unless there are big wars, you don't get big generals. If you're a military genius and you live in peaceful times, you're not going to be a great general. If Napoleon had lived 30 years later, we wouldn't have been Napoleon. So you have to, I was pilot back in the early part of when I was just beginning my career. It was a very lucky time because in the understanding of the nuclear force, one of the four forces of nature, which we finally understood. That, when I came around, there was a lot of different experiments, very confusing. Nobody understood anything. But some of my students, a few years later, when they started, it was all over. We understood everything. We didn't know that we understood everything exactly, but it was all done. So they were unlucky. So it's important to be born at the right time. That's luck, because there's nothing you can do about that. Right? You're born whenever you're born.
What is the secret of your energy? And yesterday also you were full of energy.
Well, I am a professor, and I have taught for many years. And so that's how I teach. A good teacher has to be a good athlete. You have to engage with the audience. And, actually, you draw energy from the people who are listening to you. But if you don't have energy, your audience goes to sleep. I learned over the years to communicate with the audience, and it's just the way I
teach. Sir, honestly, how do you rate Indian scientific developments on a global scale?
It's spotty. In some areas, it's very strong. In my area, actually, it's extremely strong. And that is because there are many very brilliant young Indian physicists, many of whom got their education in the United States, many of whom have come back because they have Indian culture, family, they love it here, even though they have better sense opportunities abroad. They've created a few centers and worldwide excellence. It's not true of all fields. But India has enormous potential. Big populations, you have a lot of very brilliant people, and you have a culture of good science that dates back to the 19th century. I mean, the British did many bad things, but at least they helped establish the modern scientific centers throughout India. So you have a long tradition. So I think there's a great potential for the future. At the moment, there's clearly not enough investment in science or support for education in general, but especially for basic science. A lot more needs to be done, but the potential is there.
So, Einstein was your inspiration, you said yesterday. Who was your mentor? Do you have a mentor?
Well, I've had many mentors over the years. I'm a grandson, intellectually, of Enrico Fermi. So my advisor at Berkeley, his advisor was Enrico Fermi, who was one of the leading theoretical physicists in the development of quantum mechanics and elementary particle physics.
Sir, if you were not a physicist, what would you have been?
I'm not sure. I can't imagine such a physicist.
So, do you have any hobbies, sir? What are your hobbies?
My hobbies are mostly trying to learn about other things other than physics. Mostly, I just like to learn about things.
Mm-hmm.
Or appreciate art.
What's your favorite movie?
Oh, God. I have so many favorite movies. I think that Netflix is one of the great discoveries.
And your favorite sport?
I don't really do any sport myself at this age. But
watching?
You mean watching? I tend to watch only the finals of various sports.
Mm-hmm.
So I wait all year round to the final championships of basketball.
Your favorite holiday destination?
I don't really take vacations. I try to combine them with this kind of thing.
Okay.
So now we're going to see a temple.
Mm-hmm.
India is a beautiful place. We're not visiting most of the tourist sites in India.
Okay, can I ask you, which is your favorite place in India then?
So far, I suppose, it's like asking who's your favorite person. They're all different. Rajasthan is sort of the most spectacular place there is. It's so different. But the Taj Mahal is amazing in its own way, but it's just one temple. Rajasthan is a whole country. I actually heard of my first vacation in Ladakh.
Again, your favorite cuisine?
Again, my favorite cuisine is really good food.
And finally, your favorite author?
Well, again, how can you choose between Shakespeare and Tolstoy? I have many favorites, many authors.
Now, a few words about your visit to our college.
Well, I'm very impressed with PSG, which I don't think I've seen much of the city except PSG, this PSG. But it's quite impressive. It clearly has changed the city in this region. It has a lot of potential for the future. People are very positive and enthusiastic.